Today we're going to be learning about section 8-4, simplifying rational expressions. In order to simplify any rational expression, you need to follow four steps. The first step is to factor out anything that can be factored from the numerator and the denominator. The second step is to state all the restrictions that make the value of the denominator zero. For example, in x over x minus 2, the restriction is that x cannot equal 2. The third step is to cancel out anything that is visible in the numerator and the denominator. For example, in x minus 2 times x plus 2 over x minus 2, the x minus 2 can be canceled out. And the fourth step is to state the answer. With the restrictions. Now let's do some example problems. The first example is c squared plus c minus 6 over 8 minus 2c squared. So according to our steps, the first step is to factor out. So on the top, c squared plus c minus 6 can be factored out to c minus 2 times c plus 3. In the bottom, we can take out the GCF, which is negative 2, and we get c squared minus 4. Probably you can see that on the bottom there's a difference of squares pattern, so this can be factored out even more. So it's negative c minus 2 times c plus 3 over negative 2 times c plus 2. Times c minus 2. Now our second step is to state all the restrictions. So on the bottom there's two variables, so we have two restrictions. So if c plus 2 is to be a 0, then the restriction would be that c cannot equal negative 2. And if c minus 2 is 0, the restriction is that c cannot be 2. So restrictions are that c cannot be negative 2 or 2. Now our third step is to cancel out anything that's in both the numerator and the denominator. So right now here there's a negative 2 on top and the bottom. So they cancel out. And then we are left with c plus 3 divided by negative 2 times c plus 2, where c cannot equal negative 2 or 2. Okay, so our second example problem is 2f plus 6 over f squared minus 2f minus 15. So our first step is to factor out. On the top you can factor 2, we are left with f plus 3. And on the bottom, after we use big X, we can get that f minus 5 times f plus 3. Alright, so our second step is to state the restrictions. So here our restrictions are f can't equal 5 and f can't equal negative 3. So, and our third step is to cancel out anything that's in the numerator and the denominator, which is f plus 3. So we are left with 2 over f minus 5, where f cannot equal 5 or negative 3. Our third example is a problem where you're asked to find the value of x. Given that 2ax minus 5a equals 2a squared plus 3x minus 12. So in order to factor anything out here, we need to have all the variables on the same side. So to have the a's on the same side, we can add 5a to both sides, and we can subtract 3x to be able to factor out here. So we can do plus 5a. And then you're left with2ax minus 3x equals 2y squared plus 5a minus 12. Here we can factor out an x and we get 2a minus 3. And we can use big x to factor this out. So we do 12 equals a squared 5a. And so we have 2a squared plus 8a minus 3a minus 12. You can factor out a 2. And then a negative 3 here. And then we get that 2a minus 3 times a plus 4. Plus 2a squared plus 5a minus 12. Now we can divide by 2a minus 3 and have x by itself. But before we can cancel it out, we have to state our restriction. So 2a minus 3 equals 0, 2a equals 3, a cannot equal 3 over 2. Then we can cancel out the 2a minus 3. Then we have x equals a plus 4, where a cannot equal 3 over 2.